Hello 6303. In this video, I'm going to explain how to complete the charting sources assignment in the Module 2 folder. For this assignment, you're going to need two different documents. There is a blank template available in the Module 2 folder. You can access that by clicking here or here. And then I also have the completed example that I'll be working with in this video located here. The first step in completing this assignment is locating three or four peer-reviewed articles that relate to the problem you listed in the Module 1 folder. By reading these articles, you're attempting to answer your research question, but there's very specific information you want to extract from these articles. So first, I'm going to put my research questions into the chart, which you can see I've done here. I'm using some of the articles from the text set available in the lessons folder because my research interest is how does handwriting impact composition. I'm also looking for effective methods to teach handwriting and how handwriting can be integrated into composition and or literacy skill development. The next step is to go ahead and make your APA citation of the article. This is going to prep you for your references page when you write your review of literature, and you won't have to go back and find all of that information. So real quick, let's look at what information needs to be included in an online peer-reviewed article. First, we have the author with the last name and then the first initial. If the author has more than one initial, like if they use their middle initial, you will include that as well. In parentheses, you have a date followed by a period. And then you have the article title. And what I want you to pay attention to with the article title is the capitalization. We only capitalize the first letter of the article title and then the first letter of the word that follows a colon. So when you're writing the article title, think sentence style capitalization. However, for the journal title, you follow standard English capitalization rules. So all your major words like Canadian, journal, and microbiology will get capitalized. The minor words like of, the, and a will not be capitalized. We also put the journal name in italics. Following the journal name is the volume. That also goes in italics. And then in parentheses is the issue. We do not put that in italics. Then there's a comma, the pages, a period, and if the DOI is available, you include that as well. So pay very particular attention to capitalization when you are doing an APA citation for a journal article. So once you have your research question and your APA citation of the article plugged in, you can mark if the article is peer-reviewed or non-peer-reviewed, if it's quantitative, qualitative, or a mixed methods approach. The first time that I read the article, I'm specifically looking for the information on the design of the study. I'm going to be looking for the design elements of the study. I'm recording the participants, any information that I can find about the participants, and at this point, I'm just copying that word for word out of the article. I'm also trying to describe the design, like what the tasks were, what the procedures were, what kind of analysis was done. I'm looking for the instrumentation, and I'm noting if the article mentioned any limitations that the study has. So with my example, you can see how I've responded to qualitative studies, as well as how I've responded to quantitative studies. Sometimes the articles don't have information you want. Like I was looking specifically, did they use random assignment? I couldn't tell, so I just made a note that I didn't know if it was experimental design because I couldn't decipher if there was random assignment. So fill those portions of the chart in first, the participants, the design, the instrumentation, and the limitations. The reason I'm having you record this right now is because this information will form the basis of your critiques and gaps sections that you have to write for your review of literature. So the research design part of the chart is pretty straightforward. And like I said, you can copy that word for word from the article, because eventually you're really going to condense that information down into about 1 to 3 paragraphs for all 10 of the articles that you read. So at this point, you're not super concerned about paraphrasing. The next part of the chart is to record any of the quotes that are relevant to your research question. So what I did is I pulled up my research article and I just read through it piece by piece. As soon as I came across a quote that partially answered one of my research question or could be used to answer my research question, I copied and pasted it into the chart. When I did a direct quote, I made sure to include quotation marks as well as the page number so that I knew those were not my own words. However, for those ideas that I could easily change into my own language, I went ahead and paraphrased it. I still included the page number so that I can go back and reference that later if I need to. So read through the article, record all quotes or paraphrase information that relates to your research question. Then consider how the information in your chart can be labeled. So I'm looking for an abstract term that I could apply to the information that I'm finding. For instance, it said, students in both grades pause more frequently when writing in grade 1. They are faster in grade 2 and even faster in grade 3. I categorize that as motor skills. And anything that related to motor skills, I moved under that label. But then I also noticed that this article was talking about cognitive skills, like more pauses happen because there's more use of cognitive and motor efforts. It also talked about how writing tasks increase by grade 3 and require the students to plan, organize, revise, etc. while they are writing. So I came up with these labels: motor skills, cognitive skills, emergent literacy development, handwriting in connection to composition for this particular article that I was looking at. However, in the Pull Up a Chair article, they weren't talking so much about handwriting, they were talking about emergent writers in general. So this one had different labels that I applied. I still kept emergent literacy. I found a strategy that I can use to teach my early writers that combines both handwriting and composition. I found teacher impressions of student writing and attitudes that teacher had towards writing. To show you what I mean, I'm going to see if I can apply some of the codes from the previous articles to the information in this third article that I looked at. And if I look at the first quote, it's talking about pen grip, force, kinetics. That's going to have to do with motor skills again. So I'm going to apply the label motor skills to that information. Significant differences in time, that also relates to motor skills. How the hand controls the pen cannot be measured relates to motor skills. Younger children may perform more force adjustments also. All of that relates to motor skills. They talk about the developmental trend in handwriting performance and found that writing was getting faster, smoother, and more efficient. Still relates to motor skills. And they said indicated the importance of providing manipulative activities for small muscle development, which is a prerequisite skill for handwriting. And it goes on to talk about the manipulatives used to create pencil grip. So that, I notice, is actually a strategy. So I'm going to apply the label strategy to that information. Now, you probably haven't done this before when you read, but the reason I'm having you do this is because as you read, I want your brain sorting this information. I'm actually preparing you to write your review of literature. And in another video in a different module, I'm going to show you how to take this chart and these labels that you've created and turn those into themes and into well-developed paragraphs that discuss your themes. So for now, all you have to do is complete a chart for each of the 4 articles that you found that somehow relate to your research question. Submit that to the Charting Your Articles Dropbox in Blackboard by the due date listed in Blackboard. If you have any questions, please email us through course messages in Blackboard. See you next video.